I did struggle to choose my tracks for the book, because being asked as a DJ and playing so much music and having chosen so much music over the years, to actually distill that into a 8 or 10, you know, killer tracks, it's actually really difficult. And I'm sure, ask me now, and they may be completely different. Actually, one of them wouldn't be. I would definitely put Joe Goddard and Gable in there every time. But yeah, it's hard. It's hard to, but I think it comes down to passionate and the ones, I really gave myself a few weeks to do it. So I'd look back at the list and go, are they still good enough to be on there? Yes, they are, they're staying. I think the elements of what I love about music haven't changed since I've been a little kid. My tastes may have changed in terms of where that necessarily comes from, but in terms of what moves me as a track, i.e. something to dance to, or something that just lifts me or that I feel connected to, I don't think that will have changed from the days of listening to Michael Jackson's Thriller from, you know, to now hearing something by Django Django, or, you know, and still loving The Only Ones and, you know, Another Girl, Another Planet. It's just, there is just something about the music that I've carried with me. And I have a vast array of music that I love, and I make no apologies for that. I'm a bit of a musical magpie, but, you know, at the heart of what I love is an emotional response to music, always.